My name is Mark Hutchinson. I'm an extension educator with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension. I work out of Knox and Lincoln County. So the bin size that you actually need is 3 by 3 by 3, which gives you 1 cubic yard of material for the process. And that's really enough material for most home composting processes for at least a year, or for what you're going to do during that season. When this bin gets full, you can just continually add into this bin and just fill it to the top, and you notice that there's slots on the side so the air flows into the pile and you get that oxygen that you need into the pile that we talked about earlier. And once it's filled, then you can just take this and take it out of the bin and set it off and let it go through what's called a curing process. And then after a period of time, this is going to break down into a real fine material, and you're going to be able to add this directly into your garden, or either vegetable or perennial gardens or annual gardens. Another type of bin system that homeowners really like is just a round piece of wire. This happens to be lobster trap wire. It's take a 12-foot piece of wire and make a circle out of it. And the nice thing about this is you can continually add into it. It confines the material. You can throw your food scraps in it. It has a barrier so that dogs, cats, and so on can't get into it very easily. And if you need to turn this or if you need to move it, the idea is just to lift this whole screen up, set it off to the side, and then you can actually flip the material back into it and keep using this same system over and over again. So it's a real simple system. It's really inexpensive system, but allows the whole principle of composting to occur with good airflow, good volume, and a secure place against vectors.